Now let us move to the next part of the chapter, that is seed and fruit. What is seed? A fertilized ovule develops into a seed. It develops into a seed. So after the process of fertilization, the fertilized ovule, this developed into seed. Now here you can see I have drawn different types of seeds. These two seeds are dicot seed and this is a monocot seed. In dicotyledon seed there are two cotyledons which are the source of nourishment for the seedling, because the entire endosperm is consumed during the embryo formation. This is the reason that such seeds, they are also known as non-endospermic seeds. And the other name for these seeds, ex-albuminous. On the other hand, in this seed you can say that large amount of endosperm is there and cotyledon, they are highly reduced. Such seeds are called albuminous or endospermic seeds. So cotyledon here and endosperm there are the source of nourishment for the growing embryo and not for the growing seedling, and not only for the seedling, these are the source of food for us also, for animals also. These are the basis of agriculture. When embryo is developing, when endosperm is developing, when these both structures are developing inside the embryo sac, then embryo sac is expanding. And because of this, the nucellus surrounding the embryo sac, it decreases in the size in the layers. Why? Because the function of the nucellus is to provide nourishment for these embryogeny as well as for the endospermic development. So these are developing at the cost of nucellus. So when complete seed formation is there, when the embryo is mature, then possibility is that nucellus is completely consumed. But there are certain cases where a layer of nucellus may persist, and this layer is now called perisperm. So what is perisperm? This is the layer of nucellus that is left. For example, in black pepper, in cardamom, elaichi, we found perisperm layer. Now what is the importance of seed for the plant? Seed, they are very important for the plants because they are helping in dispersal also. They are carried away to different areas. You know that when the seed is about to mature, the entire moisture content of the seed decreases. It say decreases to 10 to 12% of the dry. It is because of this that they can remain dormant for a long period. So whenever the conditions are favorable, then these seeds will germinate. The total time period in which a seed has the ability to germinate is called the viability of the seed. Again, it differs from species to species. This dormancy of the seed can be related to the presence of certain hormones. Like we have done in 11th standard, abscisic acid is there in the seed. It prevents the germination and it is responsible for the dormancy of the seed. Actually, it is protecting the seed from the unfavorable conditions. When the conditions will be favorable, then these seeds will germinate. So seeds, they help in pollination of the plant also. For human being, these are the basis of agriculture. These are the basis of our staple diet. Isn't it? Rice, wheat, maize, bajra, all are endospermic seed. All pulses, they are the dicotyledon seed. So they are a staple diet. When the fertilized ovule is developing into seed, at that time, ovary is developing into fruit. So, a fertilized ovary is developing into fruit. In botanical language, we have the word fruit only. We don't have any as such word vegetable. Okay, because every fertilized ovary is going to develop into fruit. Now when only and only ovary is participating into fruit formation, such fruits are called true fruits. Mango is one such example. The wall of the ovary become the wall of the fruit and that is called pericarp. Student, you should know the difference between pericarp and perisperm. Perisperm, I said, it is the leftover layer of the nucellus, and pericarp, the ovary, the wall of the ovary develop into the wall of the fruit, that is called pericarp. This pericarp, in case of mango, is divided into three parts: outer epicarp, fleshy mesocarp, and the hard endocarp. And inside this, there is seed. So these are the three parts of the pericarp. What about this apple? You will be surprised to know that we call it in botanical language false fruit. Why this is known as false fruit? When other part of the flower other than ovary also participate in the fruit formation, then such a fruit is called false fruit. In case of apple, the edible part, the part that we eat, is actually thalamus part of the flower. The ovary is only limited to this central part. Otherwise, this part is thalamus. Similarly, strawberry. In strawberry also, the edible part is thalamus. In this also, we eat thalamus. And the dot dot structure that you observe all over the strawberry, they are known as achene. What is achene? Achene is representing the ovary here. It is representing the ovary. Generally, this is said that strawberry is having seed on the surface of the fruit. No. Achene, this is not the seed. These are the ovaries. And the fleshy edible part is thalamus. Mango is representing an example of fleshy fruit. There may be dry fruit.